Hey Fandom fam, welcome back to my channel. I am joined with my lovely friend, Abnormally Adam. It's over here. I forget that this is mirrored screen. Hi Adam!
Hey! Thank you Emma for having me. I'm so excited to be here. This is going to be so much fun. I'm so, so ready.
I am so ready. Oh my gosh. Okay, so Adam and I are doing a collab on my channel and his channel. So I will link the video we did on his channel below as well. Today, we are going to be doing discovering new ships, essentially. So I'm going to show him three ships that he has never seen, and he's going to show me three ships that I've never seen. So picking the scenes to show each other was so hard, guys.
It's so hard. There were so many ships I want you to, and I had to so I was trying to choose ships that wouldn't spoil anything if you started to watch the show. I didn't want to spoil any big moments because you know. So it was hard because but look, I'm excited for you.
I'm excited for me. you know what? I feel like getting spoiled for ships is honestly how I find my ships. I see a GIF or something or a clip and I'm like, oh, I need to watch this show. What is that? Hello.
Literally me doing the Phantoms. Literally me. I saw it on TikTok and I'm like, what is this show? Please.
Julian the Phantoms is everything. Oh my god.
I love how we keep bringing it up, man. I can't.
We will be doing a video on that on Adam's channel. And I'm so excited about it.
Yes, we'll be doing that.
Adam, you are the guest. So you may go first. What ship are you showing me? What show is this from? Set me up here.
So this ship is from Motherland Fort Salem. I know you've been wanting to watch for a while. Obviously, if you guys watched, if Amos fans have watched my videos for Motherland, you know this ship, Raylla, is everything. And the ship's so complex, and that's what makes it so good. And the chemistry between the two actresses is insane. So I was trying to choose a scene and I didn't want to spoil much. So I got a really cute scene from episode 5, I believe it was.
Okay.
So I don't want to give context because it kind of spoils if you decide to watch it, but just watch. Just watch. Okay. That's all you have to do. Just watch.
I'm here for it. I'm just gonna absorb the adorableness.
Yes. Motherland fans, if you saw they call switches, if you know this scene, obviously episode 5. You will definitely know the scene.
Oh, no, there's no audio.
Oh, is there no audio? Oh, I think I didn't push the audio button.
This is them, right?
Yeah, this is them. This is Raelle with the blonde hair and Scylla with the brunette hair. This is flashbacks to them.
Aww.
They're witches, obviously. They have cute flashbacks, and I'm like, oh, so pretty.
Oh my god, I already love them.
Look at them. The way they look at each other.
Oh my god, the chemistry.
Thank you, I know.
Oh my. Okay, I need to watch this show right now.
So Scylla is deciding whether or not to betray her people or stay with Raelle in this moment. She's on time limit and she's stressed.
Oh my gosh. Okay. I'll stay with her.
And she chooses her. Just the way they look at each other is
their eyes are so beautiful.
Oh my gosh. Know.
I love you. What? Adam, I was so prepared. Oh my god, my baby.
So fucking good.
Alright, you convinced me. I need to watch the show.
So I'll give you a bit of context since I feel like I kind of... So Scylla works for this organization and they want her to do something to Raelle, but she doesn't want to because she happens to fall in love with her. Okay. And she didn't expect to fall in love with her. And now that she has these feelings, she's I can't, you know, and it's just she's torn and it's the angst in this show, man.
That is the best trope.
Oh, the angst. And as you said, their eyes, the way they look at each other, their chemistry is so on point.
Beautiful.
And I reckon you also like the show, not just because of the ship, but because of Srial, when she goes to this witch college, her war college for witches, where she learns how to do, you know, powers and stuff. She goes into a unit with two other girls, and like their unit, it's like girl power. It's and it's amazing.
I love it.
It's everything. Like the gender roles have like switched. Like the women are the ones who go off to war, and the men are the ones who like bend to the. It's very good. It's very good. I'm telling you.
I love that. Okay.
It
was on my list before, like, but like it's moved up the list. I will find a way to watch it.
100%. Definitely worth the watch. It's a very complex show, and the stories, I think the guy who actually created the show, there was supposed to be books. Like, he's planned them out as books, but like that as a TV show. So there's so much thought into the show, all these little details. It's so good. I reckon you'll love it. So
amazing.
Add it on.
Starting off strong. I love this. Okay, my first entry is a throwback.
Ooh, I love throwbacks.
So this is Pacey and Joey from Dawson's Creek.
Oh, I've heard so much about Dawson's Creek. I've never watched them. I've never watched the show, but I feel like I should.
It was one of the OG teen shows. So good. I don't know why it's called Dawson's Creek. It should have been called Pacey's Creek, but Pacey is just like one of the men I just love so much. So this is Pacey and Joey. They don't have a ship name, I don't think, because it was before ship names were a thing.
Before ship names, imagine.
I guess I should set up the scene a little bit. So Pacey, Joey, and Dawson are kind of like a love triangle that's like super iconic. Joey and Dawson are like BFFs, and they kind of have feelings for each other. They kind of date on and off a little bit. So basically Joey and Pacey are having a hard time with their feelings because they don't want to hurt Dawson. So they're not really sure what to do in this moment.
If you felt even one shred of what I feel for you, then we wouldn't be standing here having this conversation.
Oh my god, that is so cute!
Pacey.
The way he lets out a breath like he never expected her to turn around.
Stop! What the fuck?
Oh my god.
I love them. What the fuck? I love 2000 ship. Well, we know when they got in the 2000s. I just love like the music. It's just so 2000s. I live for it.
It's so 2000s, early 90s, or late 90s.
Honestly.
Pacey has so many iconic speeches. Like, he's so romantic, and Joshua Jackson just...
I love Joshua Jackson, man. I love him. Like, and him young, a bitch, I'm weak.
I know.
He's so cute.
He walked past me one time at work, and I just, like, died. Like,
as just if literally he just walked past you.
In my presence. Like, we were in the studio, and he was filming in a different studio, and he just, like, opened the door and walked out, and I was not prepared, and I was just like... Okay, that just happened to me.
I would die. I don't know. That's insane. Oh, maybe I have to add Dawson's Creek to my list. How many seasons are there? Are there like a lot of seasons?
Yeah, is there 10? I think there's 10.
10 inches. But you know what? I love a good,
But I'm pretty sure they were the first ones to do a gay kiss on television.
Interesting, intriguing.
And the gay character Jack has a BFF Jen, and they're the cutest together. So it's 100% worth a watch if you've got the time to just like binge it throughout other things. It's worth it.
So my next one is from Love Victor, which you haven't seen yet.
Oh, I'm so excited to watch this
and
show!
You've been dying. Have you seen any clips from the show? Have you seen anything?
No, I'm completely spoiler-free. I have no idea at all, so I'm very excited to see what you've picked.
Okay, so there were two scenes. One scene was, like, the first look that Hulu released before the show aired. Like, it will, and that's what kind of got me watching the show, because I was like, oh my god. And then there's one I wanted to show you, which it was just like, it made me melt. So like, you have to just put up two clips. It's fine. I couldn't choose. I was like, you know what? I'm gonna give you two clips.
Amazing. I also have two options for one of mine, and I'm gonna have you pick. So I'm here for two clips.
Well, one clip is only like a minute long. I'm like, no, it wasn't enough. Like, I need more. So like, watch the first.
So this give me my gaze. I will take them. Yes. I will take it all.
This is Victor like discovering himself. He's like, doesn't know if he's gay or not. He's trying to like work it out. And then he gets a job at the coffee shop where Benji works. And like, bitch, there's the coffee watch.
Oh no, you forgot the audio again.
No, I swear I clicked it.
You, I'm the assistant manager. Come on back.
Let's God, you're so attractive.
I know, don't. I had a feeling. Please, this man turns me, please.
His arms. Out of his
own. I know. Have you
experience making coffee?
I have experience drinking coffee.
Me.
It's not rocket science. You know, once you take a shot of espresso, you can.
So precious!
I know. The hair, though, like, fuck off.
The hair! Oh my god.
And while that brews, we steam it.
How is making coffee this sexy?
Honestly. Yeah,
you try. Ooh.
Hello.
You're a natural.
I am so sorry.
Me.
You know what? This is a bad idea. I'm sorry.
No, child, don't run away. Oh my god.
I know, right? I'm. That scene alone is like enough, but like. Do you want to see one more scene? Because like, I feel like you might die.
Give me one more scene.
I die. So I'll give you context. So he obviously gets the job, right? He gets the job at the coffee shop.
Okay.
And they're working, they're closing up together. And Victor plays Call Me Maybe. It's on his phone. And he's like, this song. He's like, was it him? I can't remember which one. One of them was like, this song's, it was on Victor's. He's like, oh yeah, my brother makes me listen to it. But like, really, he loves it. He was like trying to like act straight and stuff. And then this scene happens. Un moment. Let me audio this like, time.
He's playing.
I looked at you as it fell. And now you're in
my way. I beg and borrow. Oh great, he can sing too.
I know. I didn't know I would feel it, but it's in my way.
He's already serenading him. Where you think you're
going, baby? I'm dead, like
that's jawline.
I'll call him, all right. This gay panic, my child, please.
So precious. Oh, I want to adopt him. Oh my god.
Honestly, like, when I saw, you should see me, like, my reactions. I just froth over Benji, like, the guy who plays him. I'm just like, how is this? Clearly, my type is guys with, like, their hair and, like, thing. Like, clearly, that's my type.
Alex really? Is the same, so is Kevin.
And Luke, did you see, by the side note, did you see the post on Julian the Phantoms on the Instagram of Carly? Did you see that photo?
No.
Give me one second. Give me a second. I'll show you.
I'm going to look it up. Is it the... Stop!
Just like, go look at him. Like, fuck off. Like, I literally... Yes, I'm fine. Yeah.
I'm just making noises now, but I feel like you understand. Oh, I was unprepared for that today, but that made my Saturday the best day ever.
Look, as soon as I saw it, I was like, Jesus Christ, this man owns me. So funny. Oh my god. Anyways, I had to just tell you that because it popped up on my camera. Where are you? To show you
we must. All right, I'm gonna. Okay, I don't know if I can follow that one up, but I'm gonna try.
Take a breather.
This... Okay, so this is a Grizzam scene from The Society.
Yeah.
If you guys saw my video with Adam, I showed their their first kiss. So this is a scene before that. And it's very cute. I don't think I have to really set it up because it pretty much speaks for itself here. So
look at the wave. That's so cute.
Already said I could find you in the library.
Oh, okay.
Oh, 1 second. Let me just.
He did the.
Okay.
Why? This is so fucking cute, though. Like, I'm dying.
Just so weird. It gets so cute. Oh my god.
No. You don't look so impressed.
Am I supposed to understand that?
You didn't?
Yeah. What are you doing?
He's trying, bless his heart.
I wanted to say, how are you? It's nice to see you. How do you like my sign language? What? What?
This is Pia Sarah.
Yeah.
I'm Pia Sarah.
Oh, honey.
Come on, man. It's the only book I could find.
He's trying, the poor guy. Because he loves you, that's why.
No, I'm not. It's just I wanted to be able to talk to you. There's no sign. I know. I wanted to be able to talk to you, you know, in your language.
That's so precious.
They're so fucking cute.
It's so good.
Maybe I'm a society stan account now, a prison stan account, but no. This... Listen, another reason to add Netflix, why the fuck would you cancel? Like, why?
The fact that we never get them, like, the rest of their story will haunt me until the day that I die because I love them so much. Just... ASL representation! Come on, like, Netflix.
That is so important, too. Like, that, they always cancel with good rep. Like, why? Like, I don't see another, like, another... kissing booth, like, do I need another one of those? Like, no. Really? Do no. We act? Please.
The fact that they learned ASL for him, though, like,
that's so cute. The way they were just so impressive.
I'm just over here, like, I'm just waiting for a guy to open the door for me, like.
Dude, I told you, like, my standards are too high because I watch these men on these TV shows. I'm just like, my expectations are too high. Like, I can't. Real men are trash.
I know! It's the problem!
I need to stop. This is too
And here we are introducing each other to more fictional men. It's like...
Honestly, why would you do that? That is so precious. The fact that he wanted to learn. Oh! That's just because he wanted to talk to him. Bitch, I'm weak. I can't believe I cancelled that. Fuck off. I have to watch it now, don't I? All right, so my last one I'm hitting with is from Wynonna Earp.
Okay.
Wayhawk.
I feel like I probably know what ship you're going to show me because I think you've screamed about them.
Yeah, I have. Wayhawk. It's another gay ship, obviously.
Of course.
But, like, There were so many clips, but, like, it's so funny because the actual network did a dedication video to Wayhawk, 8 minutes. I'm not going to show you the entire 8 minutes, but they did this whole video with, like, all their cute moments in, like, the first few seasons. I'm like, okay, sci-fi. Yes, like, man. I love a network who, you know, stands the queer ships. I'm just going to flick and just see, because all the moments are cute. So, like, it's called Wayhawk Love Story. Just, like, flick through and just see, you know. This, I'll show you their very first meeting. So Waverly works in a bar in the first season. And
I love her already.
Oh, she is. You love her. She's so precious.
We're not actually open yet, so. Oh, right. Okay, my bad. This is my, when I see
oh my god, she's a cop?
Yeah.
They're so pretty. Oh my gosh.
God, I'm so wet. No, I keep telling Trudy he needs to fix the darn taps. Sorry,
At this point, she's in a relationship with a guy. At this point, Waverly is. Oh, this is some cute moments too.
Oh my god, they're so precious.
I'm in a relationship with a boy, man.
A boy, man.
Yep, I've been there.
So have I, girl. Oh, she's forward. I like her.
What's your problem? Oh, this is my first kiss.
Oh my god!
That catch the same thing.
That would be the other girl that went in for it. That's awesome.
What? I've always wanted to do things that scared me, but oh, it's not so easy to be brazen. And
oh,
I scare you. Yes.
I don't want to. Oh my god, they're so cute. Oh my god, I'm watching the show. I'm pretty sure
it's here. If you love badass women, this is the show for you. Like,
also, and I've been seeing that meme go around, like two characters that have never met but that would be BFFs, and I feel like Victor and Waverly would definitely be
BFFs. Yeah, the way she just melts in front of Nicole,
I think it's, that Victor and Waverly would be BFFs. They give me the same
I feel like you'd love Waverly. She's so precious, and like she has that energy, and how can you not fall in love with her? Like, she's just so pure and innocent. She's just like, oh, she's...
I saw like a minute of her, and I'm already in love with her, so...
Yeah, and you feel like badass women. And one of the main girl, her name is Melanie, she got pregnant, and they wrote her pregnancy into the show, and she was so badass being pregnant. Like, she did in a good show. And the showrunner, Emily, we love her. All about family, the women empowerment. Like, it's everything. There are so many games. It's so good. It is so good. Definitely recommend.
We need more showrunners like that and less straight white men running shows.
She full ships Supercorp, and she's like, how are the writers are? How is this show not doing Supercorp? Like, she's full is like a fan that she likes. She's like, oh, she knows. She knows.
Queen I Emily love that. We stand a queen. Okay, so this one is, their ship name is Shirbert. This is Anne and Gilbert from Anne with an E.
Oh my god, I've been meaning to watch this show for ages.
A small but mighty fandom. This show has ended, but we did get a good ending. So if you guys are interested in watching, it didn't end on a cliffhanger or anything. So there's two clips. One is like basically the payoff for the ship. It's an amazing scene, but it's like super spoiler filled. Not in terms of the show, but like the ship. Or there's like just a romantic cute scene that you could see that doesn't involve both of them but just one of them, so you can decide which one. I wasn't sure if you wanted to like spoil yourself that much for watching them or if you just didn't
like. I feel like I want to see the kiss only because I know that Anne and Gilbert get like I know the kiss because when it happened Twitter went crazy, so like I know they kiss. Like it's not like it's new information, but like I want to see it. Show me the cute kiss. Give me it. I want it.
Okay. Oh, it's so good. It's so good. Okay. Right now, Gilbert is on a train going to University of Toronto. He's been accepted there for medical school, and he's on a train there. And Diana, Anne's best friend, is also on this train, and she is going to meet Anne, who's in the next town over. So she didn't know that Gilbert would be on this train, and she's pretty mad at him. Anne's just found out some info about Gilbert, so she's running to do something.
Oh, I love when they run and they have to. Oh, I love
that. About any of this.
Had I had the opportunity to, I would have. In fact,
every opportunity for years. Admit it. You've been smitten with Anne ever since she first came to Avonlea and smashed her slate over your head. There have been countless clues, and you certainly can't deny you were beguiled by her dance practice, even though it turns out you were secretly courting a mystery debutante, who you had the temerity to step out with at the county fair with no word of warning. Then you show up at the ruins after exams and demand to know how Anne feels about you, and give her all of 30 seconds to decide her entire future. And
worst of all,
you callously ignore the letter Anne wrote to you, even though she told you she loved you.
What letter?
Yeah,
Diana, what letter?
Oh, why did I
nothing slapped apart is what letter, okay?
Never read the letter. Oh, they're running! I love when they run. I love that. They run to each other. Is she there? Please. I need this. I have. Oh my god. Oh my god, I'm dead. I have good time, honestly.
I love her dress. This is so stunning.
It's so beautiful. Oh, why is he my son? Oh, no! That's so fucking cute. Why?
They're so cute.
I just had to check.
Oh, I have a very good imagination, was real.
So I just had to be sure.
Look at me.
This is real.
Man, I have to know. Do you truly have feelings for me?
Yes. Of course you do. Oh, what the fuck is this cute for?
They're so cute and so soft. I love them. Oh my
god.
That gosh.
Is They're so cute.
So cute.
That is like, so adorable. Oh, I love a good paper. I'm weak when they run to, you know, when he runs to fight.
Running montage in a period piece. Just
give it yes. To oh. Oh, why
and we stand, Diana. Like, we stand a supportive queen.
Honestly, what a queen. Like, call him out on his... But he never read the letter. She didn't know that. And then once... Oh, but you know what? You get your best friend who will call the Shah's guy out. But obviously, he didn't read it. So then she's like, oh. And he went to fight her. That's so cute.
Without Diana, he wouldn't have gone to fight... Oh my god, it's just so cute. It was so well done. And
did they cancel that again, Netflix? Did they cancel the show? Or was it like the end? They did, didn't they?
Yeah,
why this has become a Netflix hate video. Netflix, what the hell is wrong with you? Why?
No, they cancel all the good ones. I swear, if Julie and the Phantoms doesn't get renewed, I'm gonna fly to the Netflix headquarters
honestly,
myself and egg it.
I feel like it's so popular. How can it not like be renewed? Like I don't know. Like how it has to, and it wouldn't be hard to make. Like, it wouldn't cost a lot. It might cost a lot. Who cares? I need a season three. It has to happen. Like, if they ended without, what's his name? Caleb, like, possessing the Nick, I would be like, okay, cool. But no, you can't do that to me, bitch. I need Alex and Willie endgame, please. And Julie and Luke. I don't care how it's going to happen. He's dead, but I need it.
We deserve it, is what we need. And I realize that Luke is dead, and there's no chance of it happening. But still.
Honestly, the you know what sold me? The what sold me was the dance they did in episode 7 when she like I didn't expect it. I was floored. I screamed. I don't even talk to you about that scene. I watched that scene. That's my favorite. Like I can't with that. I can't with that. I was like, bitch. Like how do you? No. Anyway.
I love them. Anyway, this is a tangent. We will definitely be doing a video.
We can edit. It's okay. We can edit.
But thank you guys for joining us. Let me know in the comments down below if you discovered any new ships yourself or if you knew all of them, what your favorite was. And make sure that you check out the video we did on Adam's channel. I will link it down in the description box below. And I will see you guys next Thursday. Bye, fam.
Bye.